I've got two beers.
No, it's not on that wall.
One from the Popular Brewery, one from Zorts. I wish I could show you what it looks like, but for some reason I've had all different angles of the pub. Every time it comes out red, so I don't like this. The Popular Brewery, it comes out white, amber, yellow. So it's cool sand, by the way. You get light creaminess there. Very white head. It's a little bit of it's the whole thing really, a little bit of butter under your tongue. Bun cup. It's nice, it's tasty. Anyway, one from the York. A little bit of dark. Darkness to it, a little bit of dampness. It cuts through the Potbelly Brewery real easy. It's not as dank as you thought, but it smells as dank. You get a little bit of damp chocolate, like chocolate that's been left from night before, like an old hot chocolate. Flavour on the palate is a little bit off wash. It doesn't come off really well initially. It comes off like it's supposed to be like this, and then it's like burning things afterwards. It's really bad. Yeah, there's no initial taste. It almost it's almost aftertaste before you taste the initial taste. There's no initial taste on this at all. It's very weird. It almost like bypasses initial taste. Goes into taste. Anyway, onto the stuff for tonight. There's six real ales, two real ciders, as well as keg beers, various cocktails. Two occasional cask beers are Acorn, which is very good because normally Acorns are so solid, and the previous times I've been here it's been good, but these two pass them. Yeah, see them. You take care. The food's really good here. Bye.